This legislation is unnecessary, and it is a real threat to the ability of legitimately registered voters to be able to cast their ballot here in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. The reason this legislation is unnecessary, because if you look at the facts, the cases of voter fraud in this Commonwealth are practically non-existent. There have been only 4 individuals convicted of voter fraud in Pennsylvania since 2004. As the Philadelphia Inquirer observed in today's editorial, this is a fix in search of a problem. We have already heard from speakers yesterday and today that the County Commissioners Association, that level of government entrusted with overseeing our election process, is against this legislation. They realize that there is not a problem, that voter fraud is not an ongoing problem in this state. And they see the dangers inherent in this law, this bill, to the ability of legitimately registered voters to be able to exercise their franchise. I should also note that if you look at the facts again, the vast majority of county commissioners in this Commonwealth are Republicans. They overwhelmingly hold the positions of county commissioner in this state, and yet the County Commissioners Association is against this legislation. We already have in place effective safeguards to ensure the integrity of our election process. A voter going to vote has to sign. Their signature has to be the signature that's on the books. The election day poll workers, the judge, the inspectors, know the vast majority of the people who come in and vote in their district. They know them by name because they're their neighbors, they're their friends. They see them on a daily or weekly basis, and they see them at every election, those who consistently vote. We also have a watcher process here in Pennsylvania. Candidates and parties can have watchers at the polling place to check on any irregularities, to question, and to challenge. And first-time voters in Pennsylvania have to bring identification when they vote for the first time in a new precinct. These are safeguards that are working, that have worked, and prove that there is no need for this expensive legislation. What must be raised today is the danger that this legislation places on our election day workers, those who work inside the polls, the judge of elections, the inspectors, the machine operators. Imagine how awkward it will be for them if this bill becomes law, to turn away people they know are legitimately registered voters, people they've seen vote consistently in elections in that precinct year in and year out. People are just there to exercise their franchise and being told, I'm sorry, you don't have a voter ID card, you can't vote today. Oh, we can give you a provisional ballot, and yes, you have to, in a very short span of time, get an ID form and go down to the election bureau and make it clear that you are legitimate. The incredulous look that is going to be on the face of these voters and the awkwardness we are putting our election workers in, the awkward position, is outrageous and unnecessary, as I mentioned. If they let a legitimately registered voter vote, by the way, if these election workers say, well, I know you, you're my neighbor, you voted in every election, I've seen you, I'm going to let you vote. That election day worker is subject to a fine of up to $1,000, subject to being imprisoned to up to a year, and will lose their own right of franchise for 4 years. That's covered in the election code under sections 3510 and 1852. It is difficult enough for us to get people to serve in the roles of judge of elections and inspectors of elections in our polling places. Now we are going to make it almost impossible to recruit people, knowing that they will be put in an awkward position to turn away people they know are legitimate voters because they don't have a photo ID, or to face the possibility of fine and imprisonment and a loss of their own voting rights. But by far, the most hurt class of people by this legislation are our senior citizens. Most of our senior citizens don't have a passport. Many of them have given up their driving privileges and no longer have a license. Now, they could never have missed a vote in 60-some years of voting. They are recognized by the voting, the election day workers on a first-name basis. And yet, under this bill, they will not be allowed to vote unless they can produce a voter ID. There is a case that was cited in today's editorial by the Philadelphia Inquirer, where in Aurora, Ohio, on March 6, the date of that state's presidential primary, an 86-year-old World War II veteran was prevented from voting at the same precinct that he has lived in for 40 years. His driver license had expired, and an ID from the Veterans Administration was not acceptable under Ohio's new voter ID law. That story, if this bill becomes law, will be replicated time and time again across this Commonwealth. And shame on us if we put a veteran in that position so that they cannot cast their ballot, someone who defended the freedom of this country. And that's what this legislation will do. The argument that they can get a free photo ID ignores the tremendous inconvenience, the hurdles that seniors will have to go through to get that ID. Many PennDOT photo centers are located in suburban settings that are poorly served by public transportation or not served at all by public transportation. So someone who doesn't have a driver's license has to figure out a way to get to that photo center to get that photo ID. A senior citizen living in a rural part of Pennsylvania will be particularly handicapped in trying to get that photo ID. In many parts of Pennsylvania, you are going to require grandparents to pay cab fare in order to get to that center to get their photo ID. 18% of senior citizens in this Commonwealth don't have a government-issued photo ID, and that's according to Karen Buck of the Senior Law Center. It is the greatest generation who has voted in the greatest numbers and consistently in our elections who will be hurt the most by this legislation. Those who survived the deprivations of the Great Depression, endured the hardships and sacrifice of World War II, and went on to build the most robust American economic period of time in this country in the post-World War era will be the ones who will be penalized by this legislation. Mr. Speaker, my hometown paper, the Express Times of Easton, published an editorial that appeared in Friday's paper opposing this legislation. Let me quote just in part their arguments because they are very salient. To quote the Express Times editorial of March 9, 2012, debunking the fraud-fighting argument is easy. The evidence of voter fraud is nearly non-existent. Even the Justice Department under President George W. Bush came to that conclusion after a five-year study looking for organized activity to skew elections. Second, making someone produce a photo ID doesn't do much, except prevent someone else from showing up and trying to vote under your name. How often does that happen? The errors that do occur often involve record keeping that isn't up to date. But even that doesn't foment much in the way of fraud at the polls. Voting is a right, not a privilege. For whatever reason, people may not carry a photo ID. They shouldn't be made to jump through hoops to fill out a ballot. Besides, Pennsylvania residents already must show proof of residence and age when they register to vote and when they show up at the new polling place if they are voting for the first time in that polling place. County officials across the state warned that checking IDs would create long lines at polling places and headaches for election workers. Those who show up without a photo ID, for instance, a senior who gave up his or her driving license, would be required to fill out a provisional ballot, then have 6 days to go to the PennDOT Licensing Center, secure an ID, and then go to the county election office with proof of identification. That's an insult to someone who may have been voting regularly for decades and is well known to the election judges and the inspectors in their precinct. Here's another reason to get worked up over a voter photo ID bill. It will cost taxpayers up to $11 million to put it in place in a state with a huge budget deficit. That is a very clear argument against this legislation. If you want to go after potential fraud, increase the number of poll watchers who can be in our polling places. If you want to go after fraud, increase the penalties for those who commit the fraud. But don't make legitimately registered voters the victims of this bill. This proposal is an affront to our democracy. It is voter suppression, pure and simple. In the name of our Constitution and the right of all free citizens to cast their ballot without unnecessary obstruction, I urge this House to vote no on concurrence in House Bill 934.